Hi there, and welcome to this video tutorial. My name is Laura and I'll be your video host. So we're going to be looking at how to use the toolbars available to you during your online tutoring. So we're going to be looking at the toolbar that runs all the way across here on the top and down along the right hand side. So you might be thinking, how do I use these toolbars to really help me interact, to communicate during the tutoring session? Well, there are a ton of great ways. So we're going to just take a quick look at each of them, and I encourage you to keep playing with them and really get some mastery of them by just playing around. All right, so the first one up here on the right-hand side is the selector. So it allows you to select things on the screen. Now, in this case, there's nothing there, so let's start adding some stuff. So I'm going to start with the pencil tool, and as you can see, once you click on the pencil tool, you're able to increase or decrease the thickness of the line and even change the color of the line. So let's say I want to draw a blue triangle. I can go like that. Now I want to maybe decrease the thickness of the line and draw in the height of the triangle. And now maybe I want to label the sides using a different color. Here's X and here's Y. All right, so I already used my first tool. Now going to the next one, we've got another pencil tool, and it's called the smooth pencil. So you can also change the color, and when you use the smooth pencil, it looks a bit more realistic, like you would use a pencil in real life. So see how it's kind of thinner and then thicker alternatively? All right, so using my selection tool now, I'm going to get rid of that because it doesn't really have anything to do with tutoring. So I'm going to select it, and then I'm going to come over here and click on this red circle minus sign, which is delete, and then I can get rid of that part right there. Okay, next tool is this little letter A is for text. So let's say you want to write the instructions from your homework so your tutor can see it as well, but you don't want to bumble through using that pencil tool. You can use the type tool. All right, there we go. And as you use the text as a test sample here, you can, if you don't unclick from it, right there you can change the font size, change the font type, and make it bold or underlined, etc. You can even change the color of the text. So that's a cool feature there. Okay, so anytime you click on something, it kind of makes a new one. So I'm going to get rid of him. Sometimes I click too much. All right, the next tool is the line tool. So if you want to draw a straight line and not rely on your own hand-eye coordination, you can use this right here. Also, increase or decrease the thickness and change the color. So drawing a line, right now it has an arrow on one side. Let's say I wanted it to have two arrows, I could click on that. Or if I said I don't want any arrows, I could click on that, and there we go. Draw another one, and it kind of keeps going back to the default. So what I just used, it'll replicate that. Let's say I want arrows on that one, just click on that and I'm good to go. Next tool is drawing squares or rectangles. In this case, you can change the thickness of the line, of course, also the fill. So maybe I want my rectangle to have a red fill and a border that is purple. So go ahead and make those settings and draw it, and there we go. Let's say I draw it and I'm like, oh, that red's a little bit bright. If I don't click off of it right away, I can change the color as it sits there. Okay, circle tool is exact same, but now it draws circles. So maybe I want to fill this guy with a lime green and leave the black border. I can also use for triangles. So now I can replicate that triangle above and it looks even neater, even cleaner. All right, you can also change if you want, using the equilateral triangle or right triangle. So you can go ahead and switch that up right there as well. The next one is cool. So for polygons, so if you've got more than three sides, or actually more than four here, you can use this polygon tool. So let's say I draw, and right now it's got five sides. Now you might be thinking, well, what if I want it to have eight sides? What do I do? Well, down here on this slider, it indicates how many points there are. So go ahead and slide it up to 8, and now you've got your octagon. You can also change the fill and all those good features. Oops, I already clicked off of it, so maybe I can't now. All right, so the next one are wedges, it says. So this is like parts of circles. Kind of looks like a Pac-Man. So without clicking off of it, I can use the slider now to adjust the angles or the degrees of the wedge. So this can come in really handy when you're working with circles. So like, let's say I want it to be 90 degrees. There we go. I've got a quarter of a circle perfectly right there. Okay, I'm going to kind of increase it so it kind of looks like a Pac-Man. Let me go up to, how about 255 degrees. There we go. All right, now without clicking off it, I can change the color there. The next tool is the highlighter. So you can change the size and also you can change the color. And using the highlighter, you can go ahead and highlight parts of things that you've written. And the next is a stamp tool. So you can change the color of your stamp and then you can pick from these items. So let's say you want to draw a star, but you don't want to have to try to freehand it, or an arrow. You can go ahead and use these tools. The trademark and the copyright, I'm not really sure when you would use them, but they're available if you ever have the need. All right, so now let's kind of focus more up on the top toolbar here. So the scissors is for cutting. So I'm going to select something. How about I'm going to select this circle, and I can hit the cut to get rid of it. If I wanted to paste it, I could hit the paste, which is two to the right from it. There's the copy one in between. So let's say I want to copy him and then paste him again. There you go. These buttons are the undo. So say I just didn't want to paste that circle. Oops, that was an accident. Let me get rid of him. I can hit undo. If I undo something, but I actually wish I had kept it, I can hit redo and it comes back. All right, so lots of cool features. This little delete button you already know about, hit that and it's going to delete whatever you've got selected. The next tool I really like, so these are flipping horizontally and vertically. So you need to use something that actually will show you a difference. So I'm not going to use this circle. I'm going to use this little wedge guy, this little Pac-Man. So if I select him and then I click on flip horizontally, you can see it flips horizontally. And if I hit vertically, it'll also flip like that. So that can come in really handy. All right, these next tools here, I have not found a use for them yet, so I'm gonna skip them and maybe add them to another tutorial. The next two are for clearing the entire page. This is considered a page, all this that you can see, or clearing all the pages. So you might be thinking, wait, there's more pages? Look down here into the bottom left-hand corner and you can see it says page 1 of 1. If I want to add a new page, I just hit the arrow over and now I'm on to a fresh second page. And don't worry, that page number 1 is still there with all the stuff you've written on it. But let's say you're working on something, you're like, oh, I just need to start fresh, but I don't want to delete what I've got. You can just create another page. Once you're ready to delete everything, you could hit clear page. But watch out, you can't undo it, so I'm going to not do it for now, but it would just delete everything on this page, or you could clear off everything on all the pages. The next tool is taking a snapshot. So if I hit that, it's going to take a snapshot of everything on my board. So here we go. I could take this snapshot, and now I could save it for future reference. So anything you guys work on with your, in your tutoring session, you can save copies of it and look back to it later, which is really cool. So as you can see, if you look up here at my bars, the web bars, it created a new page. So you could just save right from here. But another way you could do, you know, copy the image, save, whatever. But if you, you know, are right in the middle of the tutoring session, you don't want to deal with that yet, don't worry. You can also go down into here, right next to participants is assets. And any snapshots that you create will be right there. And from here, you can save them down to your computer later if you like during that session. Okay, and we're going to have another video all on assets, so look for that later if you want to look more into the assets tab. All right, the next one is the equation editor. So this comes in really handy when you want to write really crazy looking equations from your math, but you don't want to kind of bumble through it with the pen tool, and you know, or if you don't want to take a screenshot and import it, this can come in handy. So we're going to have another video tutorial just on this alone, because kind of getting used to the symbols might take a little bit of practice, but I want to let you know that that is available. Okay, so if you hit add and close window, there we go, it inserts whatever equation that you've typed into the editor. Okay, I'm going to go to a fresh page here. The next one is Wolfram Alpha. So clicking on that, it says query Wolfram Alpha for things you want to calculate or know about. So how about Newton's laws. So maybe you're working in physics. So click on that, and up here it pops information about Newton's laws. It's looking a little bit small, so let's see here. Okay, so that one showed up a little bit small. Let me start again. So if I'm in the Wolfram Alpha, let's take a quick peek at some examples of things that you could search for. That kind of gives you a nice little heads up on kind of some things that are there. So looking into physics, here we can see Ohm's Law, and then out pops something that you can really read that's nice overview about that. How about gravitational calculation? Or Newton's laws, there we go. Maybe I needed the apostrophe. Ah, it's so small. So check back for a future video and we'll show how to use this one and make sure that it doesn't look so small. But just for now, you know that this tool is available. All right, next we've got a shared pointer. So you can click on that and it can kind of use it to sort of point on the screen without dragging anything or marking it up. And the next is really nice. So this can come in great and real handy if you're going to do some graphs or something. So here, let me get rid of that. Oh, I think I need to click back on it to get rid of it. So I'm going to click on this and delete it so you can see what's behind. And you can see now there are lines. So you can select what kind of lines you want, kind of like lined paper, or maybe you want a grid. So this could come in handy if you're working on graphing with your tutor. You can also change the color of the screen. Let's say you don't like the white. You can go ahead and change it to any color you guys like. And the next last little guy over here is scrolling. So the screen can scroll down as it is now, so it can go really far down. Or you could set it to fixed so you can't scroll and you can just only see what's ever in this view. Or you can click on scale and it'll kind of scale it for the view that you're in right there. Okay, so let me get the setting back to white. The blue is a little bit strong on the blue. So those are all the tools along this toolbar. Check in with other videos to learn more about different features that you can use during your tutoring session, like assets and this text box, and more details on these elaborate ones up here. All right, so I hope that this was helpful. Happy tutoring.